A spokesman for Falak al-Rahman said both Jobar, which lies some 2 kilometers, 1.2 miles, east of the old city wall, and nearby Antarma on the edge of eastern Ghouta witnessed army strikes and shelling soon after the ceasefire went into effect. After the first few hours, there were many violations. Midnight they dropped barrel bombs, and from the morning there have been strikes across the Ghouta, Wael Alwan, spokesman for the group, said. At least 5 civilians were killed in the towns of Haymuria and Zaylamka, and fighters said there were several cases of suffocation from rockets filled with chlorine that were fired at the front lines of Jobar and Antarma, he added. The Syrian Army Elite 4th Division has been trying unsuccessfully to storm Jobar, and residents say the army has retaliated for its heavy losses by shelling residential areas, leaving scores killed and wounded since the campaign was launched. Moscow said on Friday that the ceasefire meant an earlier one announced last month in eastern Ghouta now included all the moderate opposition groups in the main rebel stronghold that stretches from eastern to northeastern suburbs of Damascus. Many fighters welcomed the ceasefire to help alleviate plight of civilians most hurt by aerial strikes, but remain deeply skeptical about Russia's readiness to get the Syrian army to stick to the terms of a cessation of fighting in several de-escalation zones that Russia has already announced. Moscow had already began to deploy military police in several areas across Syria, such as in southwestern Syria, where de-escalation zones had been announced. This shows the lack of seriousness by the Russia to put pressure on the regime, Alwan added. Outnumbered and outgunned, local rebels fortified in elaborate tunnels and deploying ambushes have repelled repeated attempts to storm their stronghold, inflicting dozens of losses on the army since the campaign began. Reporting by Suleiman Al-Khalidi, editing by Richard Bomforth.